Big trap, no clutch. Wrist rolls, don't touch. French Siri, I'm so drunk. Cause I can't drink and drive, where's my chauffeur? Find the whops off, whip that coca. I really hold this time I work, I don't floss. See, I was in the work, now my penthouse at the top. Shay said they're best friends, I bet they both. As they bought cars, cause they said I sold drugs. And when you're down, ain't nobody around. Watch they come back, when you blow up. I forgot my jacket, but my heat seems got me warm up. Fuck it, don't give me, I used to blow up.
It is a women's bantamweight matchup between Betch Kohea and Misha Cupcake Tate. All right, so here we go with round one. She is a striker. Her counterpart is a grappler. And I know as much as the grappler tends to fall in love with the hands of late, you got to think she's going to try to get this fight to the ground.
If she falls in love with the hands too much, she will end up laying flat on her back looking up at the lights. She has to get this match to the floor as fast as she can. If she does not, if she tries to stand, if she tries to get cute, she will get her clock rung and she will get knocked out.
Well, to no one's surprise, she chooses to engage in the clinch here early on, and you know, she can go for days. She can do this for 15, 25 minutes if needed.
She can do this all day. She can fight this position all day. So for her and her corner, they're very excited about where we are right now.
Nice jab, follows it up with a nice right hand. Oh, the right hand is there for her.
Look at the angle of that nice body kick. If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that.
Oh, she goes to the ankle. I don't know if she's doing that because you're in the commentator's booth tonight, but you got to appreciate that effort.
Call me entertained. Anytime I get to see something like that, I applaud it. Hats off to you, young lady.
Oh, keep it busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom. Back to the stand-up now, both fighters upright.
Oh, that was nice, John. That was nice. What a takedown attack.
Just over 2 minutes to go in the round. Well, she connects with a right hand. She loves that right hand, and why not?
It's her best punch, and if her opponent doesn't change something, she's gonna go to sleep.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. And the referee brings the fight back to its feet. No surprise there. Needed to see more action.
Big punch land.
Kohea gets crushed with that hook.
Real nice body kick land.
Just out of range with that right hand. Well, fortunate that one didn't land to the head. The hook shot blocked by Betch Kohea. And she lands a punch there. We'll see if she can start to turn these singular strikes into combinations now.
She's gonna have to find something to follow that big strike that she's landing over and over again. Beautiful kick.
With that hook, well done there by Kohea.
Oh!
Round two straight ahead. All right, so that's the end of the round. Pretty significant damage done in that round. Cut on the cheek, sustained there from that. All right, round one just okay. Round two is now upon us. How do you approach the first round in a fight compared to other rounds? I know it's a tough question for a heavyweight.
Round number one is usually the round where you gotta make sure you aren't putting yourself in any danger. We saw that for both of these young men. We saw that they were both a little bit tentative, but right now expect the action to really pick up. What a body kick.
And she caught the kick. What a strike by her there. I'd be knocked out. Her opponent still stands.
She's still standing, but she's got to get on her bike, John. She's got to get out to the center of the octagon, find some space so that she can evade her opponent from finishing.
Looking to establish the jab here. Nicely done by Tate. right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
Correa gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. Tate's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Battle for position here. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitation. She did not miss there.
She's been looking for it and she finally got it. And now she's going to see if she can close the night.
Well, oh, big knee.
You can never know.
Just a beautiful shot by her there to end the fight. I'm not sure she could have drawn it up any better than it played out here tonight. She lands the seminal blow there midway through the round. I'm not even sure her opponent saw it coming. So big, big knockout win for her here tonight. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one. And she, here's Bruce Buffer. He has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop for this contest at 2 minutes, 53 seconds of round number two. Declare the winner by knockout, Misha.